Let's also
Exactly.
get in let's also get in Gaurang Shah into this discussion. He's joining us, as well as Ravikant Bhat. Gaurang, a meeting has happened. The board is considering bids from Sitax Holdings worth $500 million. They're saying SPGP and Brych's bid $1.2 billion. They're still under discussion of what they want to do with that. So it's something that the street already knew, right? I mean, there's absolutely no outcome.
Karanya, good evening to all of you. I don't know why to have this kind of a meeting when you don't have any outcome and nothing to its logical conclusion. I mean, street knew all this. The management has been giving interviews that they are trying to raise funds. I don't understand what was the meaning of having this. And then now you're going to meet on the next board meeting to take the final decision. And even if you take a decision, Karanya, it is all up to the regulator to approve it or disapprove it. So, I mean, I think there should be something more fruitful that should be done, and some sincere effort should be put into place rather than building up hopes for the investors.
Yeah, exactly. It's all been largely around the entire build-up that has happened, the names that have surfaced. Even now, there's absolutely no clarity. Ravikant, of course, RBI is a big hurdle now for Yes Bank, but first, they at least have to zero down on some names of bidders, right?
Well, absolutely, which they seem to have done in the previous board meeting, only to reconvene another board meeting to say that the names which were being considered in the last one are no longer being considered. I think I mean, this process is getting elongated, and of the $2 billion that we heard last time, just about a fourth of that seems to be coming through, not even the $800 million. So you know, which Anand thought. Yeah, so I mean, I think this gets elongated, and one needs to just wait in the hope that some more money might come in.
Now, what does this do to the confidence of investors? Because earlier also, when the bank back in October talked about announcing interest from a bidder on the expiry date, 28th of October, the stock saw a very solid run-up. Of course, then again on 30th November, they tried to pull off something similar. The confidence has eroded massively. And once again, now today, they've done this meeting. It was a much anticipated, much closely watched meeting. And again, no outcome. What will this do to the investor sentiment?
So I think the investor sentiment has been down in the dumps since quite some time now, and what we saw basically was some bit of a hope building up. One should not be surprised, that this has actually come crashing down, because the confidence, I think, it continues to remain low. It's been so since quite some time now, and Unless you see real money really coming in, this confidence will not really build up.
There've been too much of hoo-ha around this hue and cry about this fundraising activity, which just seems to be getting delayed, and without any clarity, certainty on who the bidder is, what the bid is, and what the bank wants to do. Gaurang, how is this likely to sort of impact the stock tomorrow?
So we've seen, I think, close to 10% downtick today, if I'm not mistaken. I stand to be corrected, Karanya, on that. And, instead of giving hope and making statements, I think if you really want to bring back confidence, you need to do something very, very concrete. And not to have one board meet so that you can have another board meet to take a decision. I mean, it's rather testing patience, you know. And more importantly, one more thing, Karanya. Even if they are able to get the funds, and even if they get the approval from the regulator, that is RBI, whatever funds that comes in, whatever, amount, we don't know. I mean, earlier there was another amount, now there is a lower amount, whatever. Even if you do get the amount with you, it is only going to take care from a short to medium term. It is not going to repair the balance sheet to a great extent. To repair the balance sheet, concrete, sincere efforts have to be put in to bring down your gross and net NPA. And we all know what kind of exposure, loan book exposure, the Yes Bank has to certain vulnerable entity. So, and my feeling is that unless you have earnings turnaround, I don't think you have something, clear road path ahead of you. So instead of doing this kind of, board meets and another board meet and consider, reconsider. Finally, it will be up to the RBI as a regulator to approve it. I think it's unnecessary testing patience.
Right. Ravikant, I mean, right now they're saying they're willing to consider the Sitax's bid, which is worth $500 million. $1.2 billion from SPGP and Bryce is still unclear. So a smaller than $2 billion worth of raise, if that happens, it will definitely require another raise again, right? Because Q3 slippages, Q3 will see higher slippages, higher NPA stress as well. So tell us, how is the picture likely to shape up if this does not happen in this quarter as well, if the fundraise activity is not closed by the end of December?
See, I think the street is already, including us, we are also factoring in a kind of a flattish balance sheet. There's not much scope to grow with the amount of the quantum of capital which they have, as well as the fact that they are facing potential slippages, because what we currently have is a stress book, which is yet to fully, evolve into NPA. When that happens, you are going to see, actual hit happening on the capital. So that is when the capital ratios will get, the reported capital ratios will get severely constrained. And therefore, it's quite necessary that the capital raising happens in the near future. If the 500 million it comes through, that will be a short-term, what can we say, placebo for Yes Bank. But a bigger quantum has to come through if they not just have to stay afloat, but continue to carry on the business in the normal course.
But, if we go by the hungry child analogy, why would a Yes Bank at this juncture want to reconsider or reject perhaps a bid? Why do you think that could happen if at all?
I mean, I can only, I think there's enough said and written about the pedigree of the investors that already are there in the list. So maybe that played on the minds of the mind of the bank. But it's for the bank to clarify why they would want to do that rather than sitting here and speculating. I think, in their best interest, they decided to just go ahead with one particular investor which has put in a bid.
Okay. What are the key concerns at this juncture? Because one of the biggest red flags that a lot of people on the street have also talked about is the absence of any big bulge PE or any funds which have shown interest. There was a name of Rakesh Jhunjhunwala as well. Then once again, some news reports started coming in that he might also pull the plug and he might also withdraw his name or bid for Yes Bank. So apart from that, the absence of big names, what other concerns are at this point of time very, very apparent for Yes Bank?
No, I think there is only one concern, that is asset quality. Had asset quality concern not been there, this whole capital concern would also have got automatically solved. So what you basically have is one problem morphing into another big problem. And so right now, so therefore, to address the first concern, that is of asset quality, they are looking to raise capital. Now, you really need someone who's willing to take that hard look and play along for the medium term and be patient until the returns start showing up. So, the concern is who really is that knight in shining armor for Yes Bank.
Okay, Deven Choksi is also joining us right now. Deven, just want to understand, there was no mention of names like a Kumar Mangalam, no Rekha Jhunjhunwala. All we have is Sitax Holdings, which is $500 million, and bid from SPGP and Bright, which is $1.2 billion, which is still under discussions. What is your sense of this entire episode that has panned out? There's no clarity of future course of action either.
Well, my understanding says that today you are not in a situation of choosing the investor. Today, I think your requirement is to have money into the books of the bank and that money be given for the purpose of the stability of the banking operation currently under the provisioning that they have had, and B, I think to revive the growth in the system. I think they would require this money come what may. So obviously, I think it's a question of choosing the investor doesn't arise. As long as I think the offer is a binding offer and I think the investor is committed, probably, I think the bank will think wise to go ahead with them and I think allow the money to get into the system. How fast, how soon they bring the operations back on the track remains to be seen. And only prayer would be that I think there should not be any further downside on the provisioning part of the assets, I think, because I think that's where this bank has been suffering on the quality of the lending that they've done in the past. So these are the issues, I think, which one will have to look around for.
The more and more this gets delayed, Devin, a big question is being put on their fundraising activity. It looks tough. So, just want to understand, do we again see a return of merger talks of Yes Bank once again being discussed on the street? Because acquisition by bigger private banks was also something that was doing the rounds before the management came down and asserted that they want to do fundraising.
So, I think I would consider this way that any private bank who wants to basically buy out the Yes Bank and merge the bank into them, I think they don't necessarily see, I think, the quality of the asset that is coming along with. Because if anything which comes, which is a weak asset, which is pursued at this point of time, it could possibly mean that I think any of the bank would buy them and inviting more trouble for themselves. So that's not something which I guess I think any of the banks would probably be in hurry to do. I do agree that the valuation-wise, I think they're getting a better of the opportunity currently. But at the same time, I think the quality of the assets will have to be seen. Second thing, you buy a bank, you buy the people along with. And if it is a situation where I think they have done a weak lending in the past, if it continues in future after merger, I think that would be inviting, I think, a liability into the operation of the bank. So any sensible buyer would probably, I think twice before making any commitment, I would say so. Because I think till the time you get answer to all of these questions, I guess I think nobody will be immediately jumping into it and buying out their bank and merging into them. So yes, I think it's a long wish list, I guess. I think it's not easy to immediately account for.
Devin, Gaurang and Ravikant, thank you so much for joining us with your reactions and your sense on this big development that has transpired at Yes Bank, or actually the development that has not transpired and now will be discussed upon at the next board meet. Neha is also joining us with more details on the outcome of Yes Bank's board meet. Neha?
Well, firstly, we were expecting to hear something on the $1.2 billion capital raise from Canada's family as well as the SPGP holdings. But what we've got clearly is just the $500 million that Citax holding will be pushing into the bank. We understand that the discussions are going on. We were expecting to hear more whether this bid will be accepted or not. But what we're given to hear is that there will be more discussions going on. We are trying to get in touch with the management. We were actually expecting the board meet to go on for longer, and we are trying to get in touch with the management. It becomes very difficult for Yes Bank right now because $500 million obviously is not enough for the companies as far as replenishing their capital requirement is concerned. They are going through a downturn. They have been hit a lot by way of provisioning for all these NPAs that they have incurred over the last couple of years. But we are trying to get in touch with the management on more details as to what really is happening, because clearly this was not the outcome that one was waiting for. We wanted clear directions in terms of what was happening with the $1.2 billion that they were going to be raising. So what we can do right now is obviously just wait and watch what the management has to say.
Right. Thanks, Neha, for summing it up for us. But amid all the corporate developments, I'd just like to give you all a quick reminder of the Times Network signature event, IEC, where we will be discussing the road to $5 trillion economy at the India Economic